Okay, good afternoon. After Sunday holiday, so after one day holiday, so we are starting the lecture 11 in unit 1 in environmental engineering subject. So in the last classes, we have discussed about the hydraulics of sewers. In the last classes, we have discussed about the hydraulics of sewers. Today, we will discuss what are the types of upland tenses and what are the various collection and conveyance system of sewage wastewater. Okay, so in the last classes we have completed the design of sewers also. So for sanitary sewage wastewater ki sewer design ela undali, storm water drainage water ki sewer system ela undali ani we have designed some steps, okay, 5 steps. So we have 5 steps. According to the 5 steps, how we can design the sewer pipeline system for sanitary sewage and drain water sewage. Now, e sewer system ki sambandhinchina accessories enti. So we will discuss in the class what are the types of systems, what are the types of devices where you are using for any type of sewerage system. In that, we will discuss the types of apparent tenses, the lecture 11. Now, so what are the various materials, what are the various devices, or what are the various things physically we will add to the sewer system. Now see this one. These are the accessories. Generally, we'll discuss appurtenances. Ante, this is a technical word. It is a technical word. We will say we are calling them as accessories. So, civil terms lo cheppalante. In the civil terms, if we say in the civil terms, it is a appurtenances. Generally, if you want to discuss, it is a accessory. It is a accessory, right? So these are the various accessories. These are the various accessories on the sewer system. These are the various accessories on the sewer system, which are necessarily used for efficient operation of the system. Efficient operation of the system, right? Next, this system, which are constructed at suitable intervals. Suitable intervals means these are constructed at various length. And a sewer design piping system. For example, if you are having sewer design like this, so at some places, making some gaps, making some distances between the these devices, these are constructed to help efficient operation and maintenance. These are used to construct for efficient operation and maintenance. Right? Next. So, what are the various things we will discuss in this class? First one is a manhole, right? The second one we are discussing is drop manholes. Third one, we are discussing lamp holes. Third one is lamp holes. Fourth one is clean outs. Fifth one, street inlets called gullies. Fifth one, catch basins. Sixth one is a catch basins. Next one is flushing tanks. Next one is grease and oil traps, inverted siphon tubes, and storm regulators. So these are the various apparent tenses which are used in the design of the sewer system. So we'll discuss everything each by one. Now we'll discuss the first thing, the manholes. So what are the manholes? Generally, now this season is a rainy season. Okay, if you see in Mumbai, if you see in Hyderabad, if you see in Chennai, if you see in Karnataka, if you see in different parts of the cities, now the rainfall is the main news in the society. Now every year, every time in the month of August to September, heavy rainfalls are occurring in all over India and other countries also. So if ever the drainage system is not properly maintained in the previous months, automatically the manholes will become full. So in the news also you can see manholes open chesaru danlo manushulu padi kottukopoyaru. So these are the things you are seeing in the news. Now what is the main purpose of manhole? Generally ga cheppukoneri manushulu padtarane, but what is the technical, when you comparing with the civil engineering terms, a manhole is a civil construction element, civil construction accessories, which is done by masonry of or RCC, reinforced concrete structure constructed at suitable gaps, suitable spaces along the sewer pipelines for providing to access into them. Okay, now the manholes are the openings of either circular or rectangular in shape. So generally manaki you can see the circular type of manholes or rectangular type of manholes which are constructed on the alignment of sewer line. So meaning manholes meer chuse unta road meeda konni road ki center lo untai, konni road ki footpath meeda untundi, konni corners lo untundi. So like this you are having various types of pipelines attached to the pipelines. These are enable a person to enter the sewer for cleaning, inspection, flushing and other technical things. Okay, so these sewer lines are used, this manholes are used where a person can enter into the sewer line and inspect them and cleaning them and also flushing them. Okay, they serve as ventilators for sewers. So what it is saying here, so these are also used for ventilators also in order to escape of bad gases and other materials outside. Okay, by the provisions of perforated manhole covers. Perforated ante holes ga untundi ante small, it may be in the 5 by 5 inches or 3 by 3 inches or 6 by 6 inches square holes gaani ledante rectangular holes gaani you are having a perforated manhole covers. So if you see on the road you can see the manhole covers. Next, also they facilitate the laying of sewer lines in convenient length. They are used for facilitating the layers of sewer lines in convenient length, right? See the figures here. If you see the figures here, you can see various types of manholes lying on the road or on the apartments or in the any construction area or in any construction area, right? If you see here, the pipe, the manhole, they are installing with the tripod section, they are installing the manhole, right? Use of different sizes. So here you are having a ladder where a person can enter into this one and for inspection and for testing and for cleaning. So these are used for the inspection, cleaning and flushing operations. Now see this manhole. So manhole where it is placed in the car parking area. So these are the perforated manhole covers. See here you are having square shapes only perforated, where in order to ventilate the gases or to give some air, smell raakunda air undadaniki. So like this they are planning. See the inner views, the outer views of this manholes. Okay, these manholes are provided at all junctions or two or more sewers. For example, if you are having the manhole here, okay, this is one sewer line, this is one sewer line, this is one sewer line coming from different junctions of the areas on the road. Whenever the diameter of the sewer changes, whenever the direction of the sewer line changes, and when sewers of the different elevations join together, these are provided at all junctions. Manhole anedi prati junction ki place lo untundi. So these are making a joining to 3 or 4 or 5 or 2 or sewer lines. Okay, next point. Depending upon the depth of the manholes, manholes can be classified as, so manhole yokka depth specifications untundi kada, depends upon the depth, these are having shallow manholes, normal manholes and deep manholes. Okay, these are classified as shallow manholes, normal manholes and deep manholes. Okay, next, then the next item is, next accessory is lamp holes. Appurtenances. These are the openings constructed on the straight line sewer lines between two manholes which are far apart and permit the insertion of lamp into the sewer to find out the obstructions, if any, inside the sewers from the next manhole. Under the concept entity, the lamp hole, see this one, the pipe. So just like a lamp hole, these are used for to see what's happening in the next manhole. These are used for seeing the obstructions and yevanna blockages gaani yevanna problems, whatever the problems you are facing in the other manhole. These are used to inspect this type of lamp hole, type of manholes. Okay, these are also the openings constructed on the straight lines, on the straight sewer lines between two manholes. Under rendu manholes, so if this is a manhole, so this is the surface of the road, this surface of the road anukundam. Okay, so these are the manholes, right? So whenever you are entering into this manhole, right, these are used to permit the insertion of lamp. And the lamp manaki, so see the manhole cover, the person can enter into this one. And so this is a sewer pipeline, a straight line sewer pipeline. So this person can enter here and he can see through by using the insertion lamp into the sewer to find out the obstructions means any damages or any leakages or any changes or any blockages happening inside the next manhole, right? So like this lamp holes are used for inspection. Next, second point, this lamp hole can also be used for flushing the sewers. So sewers in flush cheyadaniki the lamp hole is also used for flushing means remove away the sewage wastewater, right? Next, if the top cover is perforated, it will also help in ventilating the sewer. Such lamp hole is known as fresh air inlet. So you could use a manhole, so on the manhole, so the manhole should not be like this. So idu manhole anukundam, so it should not be totally closed. Manaku oka solid plate laga undagoddu, right? It should be in this, if you are taking the rectangular or square manhole, for example rectangle anukundam, so manaki it konjam gaps undali. So just like your jallada laga, just like your net, fishing net atlu untundi, you are having some perforated gaps, thereby ee madhyalo nunchi the what happens, the fumes or the gases or the fresh air is entering into the manhole. So that is, such thing is nothing but fresh air inlet. So deeni manam fresh air inlet ani kuda cheppukogalamu. That is nothing but the lamp hole, which is a appurtenances for sewer systems. Next one, street inlets. The third accessory is a street inlets. These are the openings through which storm water is admitted and conveyed to the storm water or combined sewer. Street inlets ante entante, so these are the openings where the storm water is admitted and conveyed to the storm water or sewer line. Ante manaki kinda sewer line untundi, pedda sewer line pipe. So manaku road meeda corners lo ekkada footpaths meeda you are having some small junction where the rainwater is, the storm water, wrong storm water is flowing into this and goes to the sewer pipeline or combined sewer pipeline. The inlets are located by the sides of the pavement with maximum spacing of 30 meters. Okay, next. So what happens to the street inlets? These are placed at regular intervals, 30 meters spacing, the maximum pavement of 30 meters. So whenever the road is in plain condition at the footpath side, so the footpath should also be concreted. So in between the footpath and the straight, in between the footpath and between and the road, in between you are having a small gap where these street inlets are having the perforated holes where the rain water or storm water, once falling on the road, it is going into the gaps and it is entering into the storm water or combined sewer pipeline. So that is nothing but street inlets. Okay, next, catch basins. What is the meaning of catch basins here? This is also an accessory which is used for the appurtenances. The catch basins are the small settling chambers of diameter 60 to 90 centimeters deep, which are constructed below the street lines, street inlets. They interrupt the velocity of storm water entering through the inlets and allow the grit and allow, these are the waste things. What are the waste things? The grit, the sand and the turbids. and so settle on the basin instead of allowing them into entering into the sewers. And a catch basin is simply nothing but a filter. It is nothing but a filter. You are terming them as catch basins. So what these are doing, whenever the rainwater along with any waste matter which is on the road, that is sand, small rocks, debris, any plant leaves or any fruit peels, each whatever the waste material, chatta, chadaram, whatever is on the road, whenever it is flowing along with the rainwater and entering into the street inlets, so entering into the street inlets, whenever all the debris along with the water, storm water is coming into the street inlets, from street inlets, akadikalali, it should go to the sewer pipeline, right? It should go to the sewer pipeline. The accessory which is placed in between the street line, street inlets and the sewer pipeline are nothing but catch basins, simply. Okay, na? So, if this is a street inlet, road meed on a street inlet, so it is going to the sewer pipeline. If this is a sewer pipeline, in between you are having a diameter made up of 60 to 90 or 60 to 75 mm deep. So 60 to 75 mm deep, you are having a catch basin. You are having a catch basin where the grit, sand, debris are collected on that basin, and remaining storm water is going into the sewer pipeline. That is nothing but catch basins, right? Next accessory. See here. So these are the catch basins. So if this is a road, see here in the figure, if this is a road, it is a footpath sideways, the cover with the grating. So you are having the manhole cover. So whenever the debris is going into inside this one, this is automatically a sewer pipeline. So where you are having the wall and you are having some channel where everything should go into the chamber. Here the catch basin is placed in this manner. Here the catch basin is placed in this manner where it will collect the grit matter, debris matter and the waste accessories and dump it into the catch basin, and remaining water is going into the sewer pipeline. So this is a catch basin setup, right? Next accessory is a clean outs. So this is a ground line, this is a manhole cover. So if this is a ground line, GL is a ground line, means road. Okay, road meeda you are having a manhole cover, you are having a pipe which is connected to the sewer. So a pipe connected to the sewer through manhole. So what does this clean out pipe does? So it is a pipe connected to the underground sewer. Ante prati road kinda oka distance lo you are having a big sewer pipeline. Okay, in this big sewer pipeline ki different joints anevi untundannamata. So it is placed vertically or it is placed inclinedly, right? On this you are having the catch basins, the clean outs, the manholes, the manhole covers like this. Okay, the other end of the clean out pipe is brought up to the ground level and the cover is placed at the ground level. So in just the clean out, it is acting, the clean out pipe is acting as intermediate between the lower major sewer pipeline to the top ground level cover of the manhole, right? A clean out is generally provided at the upper end. A clean out is generally provided at the upper end of lateral sewers in the place of manholes. So whenever the manholes are not feasible, whenever the manholes are not available to construct on the roads, these clean out pipes are widely used in that places, right? So that is the concept of the manholes. So everything is fine, right? And the audible, right? Okay. The next one, inverted siphon accessory. So these are the other accessories where these are used in the sewer pipeline. Okay, these are depressed portions of the sewers which flow full under pressure, more than the atmospheric pressure. So siphon means, for example, what is the simple meaning of a siphon means? You are going on a bike, two wheeler. So your friend also going along with you to some place. So me friend bike low, the petrol is totally completed. You don't have any piping petrol filling station, then what you will do if you are having a pipe, a silicone made pipe, just a transparent pipe, then what you will do, just you will open your tank cover of your petrol cap and you will take one end of the pipe and keep in your mouth and take other end of the pipe and keep in the petrol tank. And then what you will do, you will suck some amount of petrol towards your mouth. At the end of the mouth, you will stop with the finger. Then what happens, it will hold, the petrol will hold due to the atmospheric pressure inside the pipe. After danger, sir, you will take this pipe and keep into your other scooter tank and release your fingers. Then what happens there, automatically the petrol is continuously flowing from your bike to your friend's bike, thereby the petrol is filling in the bike. So that is nothing but siphon concept. So that phenomena is nothing but the siphon. Okay, so these are the depressed portions of sewers which flow under pressure more than the atmospheric pressure due to the flow line being below the hydraulic grade line. They are constructed when the sewer crosses a stream or a deep cut or a road or a railway line. So inverted siphons are placed wherever the sewer pipeline is going under the water, is going under the road. So this is a highway, this is a road. Then you are having some channels anukundam to the sewer line, right? So these are the places where, this, for example, these are the different sewers. So these are the junction points. These are the junction point where you are connecting the two sewers. These are the constructed whenever the sewer crosses a stream. Sewer crosses a stream or deep cut or a railway line. So whenever you are having any obstructions on the road, for example, sewer pipeline at a certain meters of distance will in taravata, if you are having any railway line, or if you are having any stream or any culverter or any deep cut road, in such cases, this inverted siphons are used in order to flow under pressure more than the atmospheric pressure due to the flow being hydraulic grade line. So flow is generally the hydraulic grade line. So whenever the railway lines cuts or any culverters or any stream or any small obstructions happening on the road, at such places you are using inverted siphon accessory, right? Next, flat gap, flat gates and flood gates. So the other accessory is a flat gates and flood gates. So what's happening here? The flap gates or backwater gates are installed at near sewer outlets to prevent the backflow of water during the high tide or at high stages in the receiving system. So what these floodgates are using, so for example, whenever you are having a small pipe, so small pipe tisconi, take a small pipe. So if you are taking a small pipe, for example, take this small pipe. In this pipe you are having a small cut here, so this is a dead end. So whenever you are pouring some water into this pipe, what happens, it flows with a high pressure till to the end and come back and goes in this exit, right? So this phenomena is nothing but the floodgates phenomena. And ikkada em jarugutundi, whenever you are installing the backwater gates, whenever the water is coming towards the other end, it will prevent backflow anedanni prevent chestundi at high stages of receiving system. So whenever you are having high stage of sewer receiving system, at that place the sewer water ni prevent cheyadaniki we are using flood gates. Why? Sewer water anedi oke line lo forward line lo undali, should not come backwards. So backward raakunda undadaniki em cheyali, we are using the flap gates and the flood gates, right? These gates can be rectangular in shape or circular in shape and can be made up with wooden planks or metal alloy sheets. So whenever coming to the materials of these flood gates, this can be prepared by using wooden material or using metal alloy material. Okay, so these are concepts of the flood gates. This is a concept of flood gate. Next one. What is the next one here? Drop manholes. The next concept is drop manholes. So what is the purpose of drop manholes? See here, in the manholes construction, so you are having different the rings. The cement rings are placed inside the ground, and they are totally masonryed. And finally, you are having a continuous manhole where a person can enter into the manhole, and he can do so many inspection, repairings, paintings, any alternatives, etc. Right? So whenever the sewer, whenever a sewer connects with another sewer, where the difference in level between invert level of the branch sewer and water line in the main sewer at maximum discharge is greater than the 0.6 meter, a manhole may be built either with vertical or nearly vertical drop pipe from higher sewer to the lower sewer pipeline. So these manholes are generally used in between the two sewer pipelines. For example, see here. So this is a road construction. This is a road construction. So this is the upper surface of the road. So this is a bottom place where you are making the concrete solid place. At one layer, you are having the sewer like this. So below it, again, you are having the other system. So these drop manholes, where a person can enter into the manhole and can work without any problem, where the manhole may have either a vertical or a drop pipe from higher sewer pipeline to the lower sewer pipeline. These are the drop hole accessory. Okay, na? So these are the main types of appurtenances which are used for designing of the sewer pipeline. Right? Understood? The Gavini, Jyoti, Kuruba, Janu, Maunika. Okay. What is the next one? The next concept is types of collection systems. Andariki ardham avutundi kada? Just message me or just raise your hand. Those who are listening, everything is fine, right? Audio and video. Just message me or unmute yourself and say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Only girls unnaru ante boys evaru deentlo? Boys andaru cricket kellara? Okay. The next topic is the types of collection systems. So these are also the separate systems where the rainwater or the sanitary water are collecting and storing. So where you are collecting this collection water, this wastewater, sanitary wastewater, storm water. Generally, ee rendu untundi society lo. First one is sanitary wastewater collection and rain storm water collection. So ee rendu final ga ekkadiki collect avvali, right? So what is the source? What is the destination? Source enti, destination enti, right? Now we'll see in this topic. What is the next one? Sanitary sewer collection systems are responsible for collecting and conveying the wastewater. So these are used for collecting the wastewater and conveying where it is going. So collection is one thing and conveying is a other thing that is generated at residential dwellings and wherever we are living. Residential dwellings means wherever we are living. Dwelling means the living areas. And commercial and industrial buildings to the wastewater treatment plant for the treatment. Okay, na? So collection system chesin tarvata what they will do? So in the initial classes we have discussed the water should be collected, treated and distributed, or it should be disposed. So three things jarugutundi water ki em jarugutundi. First, they are collecting the wastewater. Okay, then they are treating the wastewater in the treatment plant, then they are disposing or distributing the wastewater. So these three things happening generally in the residential areas, industrial areas, commercial areas, or any storm water, or any hilly or rocky areas, right? So what are the various types of collection systems? Yeah, see this one. The first one is a gravity system. The second one is a low pressure system. Third one is a vacuum collection system. So these are the three types of collection systems where the wastewater is collected from one place to the other place. Now see in detail what are these three types of system. First one, you'll see the gravity type of collection system. So what happens here? The primary type of public sanitary sewer collection system is a gravity system. Okay. So gravity means natural pulling of the earth. So whenever you are designing a sewer system, whatever the appurtenances you are maintaining the sewer system, the first thing you have to maintain is how it should be collected, where it should be treated, where it should be discharged. Okay, now these are the three points. These are the three points to be discussed. So the primary objective of the collection system, ENT, the first thing it should be a gravity type of system. Gravity type of system means the cost is low, the maintenance is low, right? The output is good. So like these are the advantages. So what? Okay, so we are having some technical problem. So again, we are continuing here. Okay, so in this type of gravity system, a gravity system is so named because the wastewater flows down gradient in the sewer driven by the forces of gravity. So here you don't have any electric system or motor or pumping mechanism in the gravity type of system. The phenomena is the wastewater is flowing downwards with the force of gravity. So that's happening in the type of gravity system. The next one. Various sizes of sewers are generally laid at minimum slope to ensure open channel flow through the pipe at a minimum velocity of 2 feet per second. The minimum velocity is required to ensure that solids do not settle out in the sewer. So generally, solids will not settle in the sewer. So it should be taken out. So whenever you are using the various sizes, diameters, lengths of the sewer lines, it should be laid down with a minimum slope. So when slope is slow, the slope should not be very drastically. The slope should be minimally. We have to design based upon the road conditions. Based upon the road conditions, then only whatever the solid matters should be retrieved outside from the manholes or the covers. It will be easily removed without any problem. What is the next one? The gravity sewers are the minimum of 8-inch diameter pipes. So in this gravity sewer system, low, what would be the diameter of the pipes? It should be 8-inch diameter pipes with manhole structures located at changes in the horizontal alignment and vertical slope changes. The maximum distance between the manholes are 400 feet. So what is the maximum distance between manholes? It should be around 400 feet distance. And what is the pipe diameter in this gravity type of system? 8-inch diameter pipe. And the manhole structure is located at changes in the horizontal alignment and vertical slope changes. So whenever you are seeing the alignment of the sewer pipeline, so the horizontally and also the vertically, you are having some changes and you are keeping for the alignment. In that way, the gravity type of systems are used with various apparent tensors. Next. So if you see the gravity type of collection system, so these are the commercial place, these are the residential places where you are having in any street. Then how the home collection system can be done? So with this, you can see all the wastewater, derbies, whatever the sewage, sanitary sewage is flowing from all different houses, depends upon the various quantities. All are flowing into the gravity type of sewer line. And these are what they are doing. They are going for the pumping station to decentralized treatment facility. So these are pumped to the pumping station for what? For treating the wastewater. This phenomenon, this concept happens in the gravity type of sewer system, right? Second one. Okay. What is the second one here? The second one is a low pressure system. So in the low pressure systems are used in the areas. These are used in the areas where the use of gravity sewers is a problem. So ekkadaithe the gravity sewers is a problem and impractical due to the topography. Topography means we are discussed that is a the geographical area. It may be the hilly areas, rocky areas, or maybe any hill stations, and also for economic reasons. So instead of using gravity sievers, low pressure systems are used just a rule. Next, the low pressure systems are often found around lakes and in rolling terrain. So the low pressure systems, ekkada we can place, these are found around the lakes, wherever the lakes, number of lakes you are having in the locality, and also in the rolling terrain. Terrain means the hilly areas where it is difficult to lay for the gravity type of system. Next, the wastewater is collected on site. The wastewater is collected on site and pumped from a small grinder pump. So the here the water is collected from the on site and the particular place, on site and the particular place, and pumped from the small grinder pump into the small diameter force main system. The private force main discharges into the larger public force main. And ikkada em jarugutundi, if you are using the low pressure system, the waste water anedi em jarugutundante, these are collected from the particular area and pumped through the pump, and pumped through the grinder pump into the small diameter force. And a small diameter pipeline loki, these are pumped into the small diameter pipe. Then what happens, the private force, whatever the outside services, what they are doing, they will take this small force of garbage or sanitary waste from here to and discharges into the very large place where all the small dumps. So ekkadaithe meer teeskochi pumping lo chesi collect chestaro avanni malli the private force vallu em chestaru, they will take all the small wastewater sievers and collect in a big public domain. So that's happening in the low pressure system. Next one, a check valve is used near the end of the private line to prevent the wastewater in the public force main from the entering into the private force main. So ee process jarugutunnappudu for coming from the household going into the your small private pipeline, and from here is going into the larger pipeline. E transactions jarugutunnappudu, what happens, a check valve ane oka accessory is used near the end of the private line to prevent the wastewater into the public force. So in order to prevent the excess amount of water coming from the private areas to the public areas, a check valve is used in order to prevent the wastewater entering into the private force main supply. So that is happening in this low pressure system. Okay, na. Next, in most cases, the low pressure domain force, in most cases, the low pressure public force main then discharges into the public gravity collection system. So generally, what's happening, whenever the waste is coming from the household to the low small space, from here it is going into the public place where it is a large place. So these are discharged into the public gravity system. It's not discharged into the public gravity collection. Now, if you see the figure like this one, so if you see the legend, so the spot lines are pressurization units. So this one, see the spot lines. These spot lines are pressurization unit. Next, the dark line is showing the service line. The dark lines are showing the service line. The very dark line, the very thick line is showing the pressure main pipe. So thick line is showing the pressure main pipe and connector valves and clean out. See the dotted lines are connected rods, and see these dotted lines are connected rod and the clean outs. These are the clean outs.